What enthusiasm. Maria, it's her birthday. Give her a nice hand anyway, will you? A nice hand for Maria. And we have a happy anniversary. Oh, this is a happy anniversary for Maria and Mario. Is that the same ones? Ah, double way to go. And 24th anniversary of Mr. and Mrs. Esposito. That's over there, too? 24 years, folks. Give him a nice hand, huh? That's it. Oh, boy, I must tell you about this fella. He used to come home loaded every night. And his wife used to stand at the door and scream and holler at him, trying to get him to stop, and she couldn't. So she asked her girlfriend what she should do. And her girlfriend says, try a little reverse psychology. And she says, what's that? She says, treat him with kindness. So the next night he comes home smashed again, and he goes to put the key in the door, and the door swings open. His wife is standing there with a negligee and her hair all made up, and she says, come in, darling. Takes him into the kitchen, sits him down. There's a wonderful meal there. He's enjoying himself. Says, anything else you like? He says, no. He says, this is wonderful. She says, well, we might as well go to bed then, huh? She says, yeah, we might as well. I'm going to get hell when I get home anyway. Well, it could happen. You know how that's. See, this drunk is driving down a one-way street, and the cop stopped him. Said, didn't you see the arrows? He said, I didn't even see the Indians. Must have heard that one about the Indian didn't know heads from tails. Brought home the darndest scalps you ever did see. Of course, if you don't drink a lot and relieve all the tension and get rid of your problems, you wind up seeing a psychiatrist. That's the big thing today. And some of the stories they have. I had this one scene where this fellow comes into a psychiatrist's office, you know, and there's this lady standing there with a duck on the leash. And he can't believe it. And the psychiatrist comes out and he says, madam, what can I do for you? And she says, well, it's nothing for me. It's my husband. He's a duck. I think I'm facing the wrong way. This fella comes into a psychiatrist and the doc, he says, I have trouble remembering things. He says, like what? He says, like what? Psychiatrist turned to the patient. He says, you're cured. You have nothing to worry about. Everything's all right with you now. He says, thanks a lot, doc. Give me a kiss. He says, no. He says, I told you you're cured. Everything. He says, I know, but I've been coming here for 3 years and the least you can do is give me a kiss. He says, are you kidding? I'm not even supposed to be lying down the couch with you. This lady comes rushing up to a cop, and she said, I've been attacked. The cop said, when? She said, 20 years ago. He said, well, what are you telling me about it now for? She said, well, every once in a while, I like to talk about it. This lady called at the police department and said, there's a sex maniac in my room. Pick him up in the morning. Busy. I'd like to talk to you about television and all the different shows that they have on TV, like the early morning shows where they give you the gossip on the new clubs that are being formed. They have a new club now called Nicotine Anonymous. It's for all you people that smoke cigarettes. You want to give it up, you join the club, and you wake up in the middle of the night and find you just have to have a cigarette, and you call up the club, and they send a member over, and you get drunk together. Do real good, they put you in the other club. You know how that. And they have the flashback programs, too, where they bring you the political voices from out of the past and the present. They help you reminisce. Something like this. A voice has a way of cutting the hazy fog of time and bringing sharply into focus the image of yesterday. Do you recognize this voice?
The only thing we have to fear is fear itself. And this nation has a rendezvous with destiny.
Yes, that was Woodrow Wilson. So few of us left him. And now the voice of Harry S. Truman. My fellow Americans, if I could offer you but one watchword in the coming months, that would be work, work, and more work. I'm going fishing. And now we take you to Washington, D.C., and John F. Kennedy. And I'd like to state at this time, regarding the Cuba situation, that I decided to buy Cuba and sink it. And now, the other side of the coin, Premier Khrushchev, Russia's Mr. Clean.
Yes, Antonomashordaya, Vishayashigambramishadai, is Disneyland crushed, no Namishalayim is.
The Premier has just stated that Disneyland is a fairyland and has just given the world 24 hours to get out. And now at this time, we take you to the United Nations, where Kasavubu from the Congo is about to address the United Nations. He's walking up to the podium, placing his notes before him. Kasavubu.
Well, did I ever tell you about the time I was with the Mau Mau?
And now we take you to Gettysburg and a word from a former president.
Four.
And they bring you the news every hour and the hour. They have that. And winning all the awards now, the Huntley Brinkley Report and David Brinkley.
A rocket fired from Cape Canaveral with an atomic warhead attached to be fired in outer space is now heading back to Earth toward a principal American city. We'll have the name of that city for you in just a moment, but first, a word from our sponsor.
Well, everybody has to make a living. You know how those things are. Did you ever hear some of these commercials that they have? Like they're advertising this Playtex living bra, and people are afraid to buy it. They don't know what to feed it. Oh, and have you seen that commercial where the fellow's in the bathroom shaving, and the girl pushes the door open, and she says, "Good morning, Mr. Gray." Have you seen that? And he turns around and says, "Good morning, Mrs. Harrison." There's something like that. I don't know how to say it. They have one fellow on TV that's been making $1 million by being half asleep through everything that he does. He's a retired barber, and this is one of his all-time great songs, If I Loved You.
If I love you, words wouldn't come in an easy way. Round in circle, I go. If I love you, when I love you.
They have another fellow that's been holding forth every Sunday for the last 14 years, one of the top-rated variety shows, and he always has a guest or two, something like this. Next week, we're going to have you right here on our stage, right there. Or is it over there? We're going to have you 400 penguins. They're going to come out here and sing Tuxedo Junction for you. And I was sitting out there in the audience saying, how about a really big hand for General Charles de Gaulle? Hi, Chuck. Right about now, we'd like to make way for Sir Tony Bennett and one of the really big tunes for Tony. I Left My Heart in Cincinnati.
I left my heart in San Francisco, high on a hill. It calls to me when I come home to you, San Francisco. Your golden sun will shine for me.
And then, of course, who could ever forget from Camelot, a very beautiful song is sung by Robert Goulet. If ever I would, if ever I could, what was that? If ever I would leave you.
If ever I would leave you, how could it be in springtime, knowing how in spring I'm bewitched by you so? Oh, no, not in springtime, summer, winter, or fall. No, never would I leave at all.
Jerry Lewis and Rockabye Your Baby.
Weep no more, my lady, mammy, sing that song to me. So soft and low, just as though you had me on your knee. A million baby kisses I'm gonna deliver the minute that you sing Swanee River. Rock-a-bye, you'll rock-a-bye, baby, with a Dixie melody.
And one of the newest shows on TV is a little thing called Drink Along with Dean Martin.
When the moon has your eye, like a burger piece of pie, that's the morning. When the world is that's the sign, like you had too much wine, that's the morning.
Wait, 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 stop the music. I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Seagrams for voting me Man of the Year. They said I drink a quart of whiskey a day. Hell, I'd spill that much. That's it. Well, I always get a big kick out of watching that fella on TV as directing pictures out in Hollywood. Now he's got his own show. Because I'm something like this.
Good evening. This is Alfred Hitchcock presenting an unusual story of horror and well. It's a nice story. Stars. There's Peter Lorre, Mr. Sidney Greenstreet, and Mr. Boris Karloff. It's a musical. And there is Mr. Sidney Greenstreet saying,
"Come closer. Closer still, as I take her across the Pacific. There we enter a dingy waterfront, up a dingy flight of stairs, into a dingy room, and there on a dingy shelf ticks a dingy clock. Listen to it ticking. Dingy, 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 dingy. Pleasant, isn't it, just to sit and listen to the clock. Listen to it. Yes, it's 11 o'clock. And there sitting at the table is my dear friend, Mr. Boris Karloff, and he says,
I get along without you very well. Of course I do. There, that song reminds me. I must tune in on the hit parade and hear my favorite singer.
And now the number one song hit across the nation, the tune that all of you have been waiting to hear, Ebb Tide, is sung by Peter Lorre.
First the time rushes in, plants a kiss on the shore, then rolls out to sea, and the sea is very still once more. So I rush to your side, right the oncoming tide, with one burning thought as I stand by your side. At last, we're face to face, a tide that keeps waking and breaking out. I can tell, I can feel, you are love, you are real, really mine.
God for relatives.
Do we miss any of your favorite singers that I might know that you like? That, Russ Colombo. I bet you want to hear the scratch in the record, too. Russ Colombo. What? Mario Lanza. It's going to be a wild night, folks. What? Frank Sinatra, Frankie Lane, Elvis Presley, Bela Lugosi. Is he recording now? I thought he was. They come out so fast, I don't know. What was the other one? Who was that? Yes. Keep going, you'll pick one I know. What? Connie Francis. I'd love to do her. But never on Sunday or something. What's that? Al Jolson. Joe Jim Cohen. Elvis Presley. Johnny Ray. Mickey Mouse. Bing Crosby. All right, we got enough. We're into next Tuesday. All right. One of the first requests we had, Nat King Cole, and that beautiful number by Nat. Mona Lisa in C, I think it is.
Mona Lisa, Mona Lisa, man who names you. You're so like the lady with the mystic charm. Is it only 'cause you're lonely, man have claimed you? You're so like the lady with the mystic charm. Is it only 'cause you're lonely, all alone? Lonely, lonely, all alone, that's what you are you warm, are you real, Mona Lisa? Or just a crazy mixed up lovely word? How
And the other request we had was for Vaughn Monroe and Racing with the Moon and B-flat. B-flat, was that a key? I don't know.
Racing with the moon, I am in the midnight blue, and all too soon, we're doing the mambo.
That's the first time I had two requests in a row I could do it. It's funny, it worked out that way. Yes. And what was the other one? I forgot. Russ Columbo. You never forget. What was his big song, Russ Columbo? Prisoner of Love? Prisoner of Love. Remember that? All right, what the hell. An E-flat, try. That's a key, I think.
Alone from night to night, you'll find me too weak to break the chains that bind me. I need no shackles to remind me.
That's all I know of that one. What? Well, he died. Huh? Bing Crosby? Certainly. Bing Crosby. Prisoner of Love.
Alone from night to night.
You've... Pretty old records, aren't they? Bing Crosby and a beautiful song by Bing in keeping with the coming holiday, White Christmas and B-flat.
I'm dreaming of a bye Christmas with every Christmas God I write. May your days be merry and bright, and may all your Christmases be bright.
Frankie Lane, and That's My Desire in C, I think it is.
To spend one night with you in our old rendezvous, in reminisce with you, that's my desire.
We had a request to do Mario Lanza, and we'd like to do that for you now. Mario Lanza, and that great song by Mario Lanza from the Picture Picnic, Be My Lunch.
Be my love, and with your kisses, send me burning. One kiss is all I need to seal my fate, and hand in hand we'll find love's promised land. There'll be no one but you for me eternally. If you will be
I think I hurt myself. It's a weird feeling, I want to tell you. After 40 years there. Oh, God. I don't think they'll ever bring him back. We'd like to do a very beautiful number for you on the violin, as played by Jack Benny in a recent engagement on Broadway at the Ziegfeld Theater. Mr. Benny, play the violin! Been a wonderful audience tonight. We'd like to tell you that we have lots of good things to eat and drink and plenty of dancing and fun tonight. And stick around, because the more you drink, the greater the shows get. I'll have to save that for then. Say, we're going to be back in a little while, I guess, or something. So have fun, and thanks a lot on behalf of all of us up here.